Hi friends, so again, you know, we are here back with another question, and in this question it is said that if P, Q, R are real and P is not equal to Q, then show that the roots of the equation P minus QX square plus P times P plus Q minus 2 times P minus Q equals 0 are real and unequal. Okay, so the keywords are real and unequal, isn't it? These are the two keywords. So what do I know? What do we know about this? So if the roots have to be real and unequal, then what is the condition? So we know for any quadratic equation, if roots are, for roots to be real and unequal, okay, condition is D is equal to B square minus 4AC must be greater than 0. What are B? What is B? What is A? What is C? So we know that if and B and B, A and C are nothing but coefficients of the variables here. So AX square plus BX plus C equals 0. So this was the quadratic equation. If this quadratic equation has to have real and unequal roots, then this condition must be true. So let us find out in the given, so our given equation is this one. So what are the values of A, B and C? So I will write it out like this. A is here is P minus Q, isn't it? B is clearly 5 times, oh sorry, I have missed an X here. Yep, correct. So this is X. So hence B will be equal to 5 times P plus Q, and C is equal to minus 2 P minus Q, correct? So let us find out what is the B, what is the value of D here in this case. So D here is 5 square P plus Q whole squared minus 4 A. A is P minus Q and C is minus 2 P minus Q, right? So hence it is nothing but 25 P plus Q whole square. I'm purposefully not opening this bracket. I'll tell you why I did that. And minus minus in this, the second term is 8 times P minus Q whole square, right? Now, if you see guys, 25 is a positive quantity. Now, any square is, yep, greater than 0. Why? P plus Q whole square is greater than 0. Why? Because squares are always greater than, or I should write greater than equal to, because it can be 0 also, are always greater than equal to 0. But it's given, it was given, if you see, what was given, P is not equal to Q. Okay, so we'll be using this particular information here. Now in the second term, you see, P minus Q is greater than 0. I'm not writing greater than equal to 0. Why? Because P is not equal to Q given. So definitely P is not equal to Q, then P minus Q is not equal to 0. So definitely P minus Q whole square will be greater than 0, because squares are never negative. Okay, that means 25 times P plus Q whole square, which is a positive quantity, greater than 0. This is clearly greater than equal to 0. If P was equal to minus Q, then it will become 0. And 8 times P minus Q whole square is certainly greater than 0. Now if you add both of them, what will you get? You will get 25 P plus Q whole square plus something which is greater than 0. I'm adding something which is greater than 0. So clearly it will be greater than 0. It will not be equal to 0. Why? Because this quantity is always greater than 0. So hence the total, I'm adding something to it. So hence total will always be greater than 0. Right? That means what? D in this case is greater than 0. And this is sufficient condition for real and unequal roots, guys. Okay, so the given equation, this given equation will always have real and unequal roots.